We run globcon and select the Ethernet adapter we want to use to communicate with other globcon users and share the control over the network. Locally connected devices, via USB for example, are automatically detected and listed in the local tree. If we want to control all the local devices, with a single click on each, we bring them on our global view. No matter if the local devices are in our global view, they will be available for other users through the network. In our example, they are grayed out since we have them already under control in the global view. To control devices equipped with Ethernet ports, we will proceed in two steps. We add virtual devices, an Xbox MD, an M1K2, a Monton 42, and a generic web view. Once all the desired devices are on the global view, we can save some desktop space hiding the selection tree. A click on the globe icon opens the list of the devices. The ones connected via USB have a unique ID. Let's click on Edit and enter the actual IP address of the Xbox MD. Click on Assign and then on the Pull button. The communication with the real device starts and the Ethernet icon becomes green. Let's repeat the operation for M1K2 and Monton 42. For the web view, we have the possibility to enter an IP address or an URL. We can also copy and paste it, for example, from a browser and then store it with a click on Assign. With a double click, we can now open the globcon browser for Xbox MD, Monton 42, and the web view, where, in this example, we can manage the Ravenna drivers. M1K2 is a very good example of globcon hybrid control. Some parameters are managed in the native globcon style, such as port routing and metrics, while for anything else we can get through the browser tab, log in and have full control. It's quick and easy to trim some parameters straight from the global view. With a click on the meter, a pop-up fader offers mute, unmute and level adjust with mouse or gestures. A double click on the device name opens the home window where more info and controls are available, organized in several tabs. Even if the meters represented in the global view may be pretty small, a click pops up a full-size fader for quick trimming. To maximize the performance dimension ratio, devices with high channel counts offer homepage with mid-size meters and pop-up faders for quick trimming. The input tab offers full-size meters and faders. Keeping shift depressed, we click on several channels to create an input multi-selection, represented in red. We can clear the multi-selection by pressing the ESC button on the keyboard. Shift and mouse drag is another way to quickly multi-select channels. A click on the red MS button is another way to clear the multi-selection. Globcon offers Windows auto size and position management. When more space is required, the Windows is resized and temporarily moved up to allow full access during the operations, and automatically goes back to its original size and position whenever convenient. This and lots of other globcon tricks drastically improve users' productivity and experience. More videos will follow soon. Stay tuned on globcon.pro.